All right. That exercise 1 year, last question I want to discuss with some more explanation related to it. Okay. I want to call this Apollonius circuit. If you want in the class notes also, you can write this like little bit of theory. If you want, you can write in the class notes also. You're not required to know about this, but it is nice to know. It will give you some better idea. What is this? Let us say I have point A, some x1, y1, and point B, some x2, y2. In the coordinate plane, two points, two distinct points. Okay? A is not equal to. If somebody asks me PA equal to some constant into PB, they may ask PA equal to 2 PB, PA equal to 5 PB, PA equal to 1 by 7 PB, like this, some positive number. Then what is the locus of P? Okay. It will come a circle as long as it is not 1. If K is 1, if PA equal to PB, what is the locus of P? Anybody?
Right line, perpendicular bisector along A and B.
Yes, it is perpendicular bisector of AB. So let me write the statement. Okay. If A and B are two distinct points, or let A and B are two distinct points in xy plane, locus of P x comma y, if P A equal to K into P B, is Roman 1, a line that two perpendicular bisector of AB. If K equal to 1, a circle, okay, if K greater than 0 and K not equal to 1. But I want to tell something more about this circle. Let I be the point dividing AB internally in the ratio K is to 1. Let E be the point dividing AB external in the ratio K is to 1. Locus is a circle where locus is the circle with I and E as ends of diameter. I and E as n of diameter. This I'll explain after this, okay? But you can write this in the class notes. Write today's date, everybody, in the class notes. Sorry, something is blocking the screen. Okay, right. So, Apollonius circle. All of you know Apollonius theorem in the triangle, that is different, is slightly different. But the mathematician is same, same Apollonius. Okay, so when K is 1, it represents a line under 2, perpendicular bisector AB. Whenever K is not 1, it represents a circle. And what is that circle is, divide A and B internally in the ratio K is to 1, external ratio K is to 1, you get 2 points. Take those to the ends of diameter. I'll explain more about it, but try to write. Somebody is not able to read some part of it, tell me, I'll read it for you. Today, in the beginning of the class, you could not join, huh?
Yes.
Yeah, it was coming in another meeting or something. Started a little late. Okay, some of you in the beginning of first year in the online, you could not attend classes properly, various reasons. And maybe you don't know the seriousness of the studies at the time or importance, or maybe you have network issues and just after 10th class, you could not get adjust all that. Okay, so all that is done and you are almost prepared for first year board exams, even though they were not conducted. Okay, so with that experience, please understand second year you have to take very seriously. Because we may be losing a lot of time in second year if they keep again first year board exams. And you have your mains and advanced exams and all that. Okay. So it is difficult for us to run after each and everybody, whether they're doing homework and all that. Okay. So you have to be sincere. So please take responsibility. You should not say later on, sir, I have not understood anything in circles. I can teach, but I'll not be able to teach this much extensively at that time. And they are very simple. If you follow every day that day's homework and read it, it's actually very easy. Okay, I'm arranging this whole thing. Neha, are you there in the class?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have you finished first exercise 1A almost fully?
Yes, sir, I did.
Okay.
Sir,
I'm arranging this whole thing. Saket, completed?
Yes, sir, I completed, sir. Sir.
Okay. For this explanation, why it is a circle? Actually, by pure geometry, it's difficult to understand why it is a circle without explanation. But coordinate geometry is very easy. I'm sure some of you might have completed. The logic is very simple. Let A x1, y1 and let A be x1, y1 and B be x2, y2. Okay. In IP textbook, they gave any points. Just for idea, also I'm writing solution. Let the given distinct points be A x1 comma y1 and B x2 comma y2. Okay. let px comma y be any point on locus. PA is equal to k into p. This is what they did. Or PA by PB is equal to k by 1. PA equal to k. Square it, you'll get PA square is equal to k square PB. What is PA distance? X minus x1 whole square plus y minus y1 whole square. K square into x minus x2 whole square y minus y2 whole square. If I expand it and bring one side, I can directly write x square into 1 minus k square, y square into 1 minus k square. X coefficient is minus 2x1 plus 2kx2. I can take 2x1. 2x into minus x1 plus kx2. 2y by 2y into minus y1 plus ky2. Plus a constant x1 square plus y1 square, not four times. Minus k square x2 square minus. So what would any very simple? They said PA is k times PB, they want locus of P. Take PA x comma y, apply distance formula here, distance formula here, you got an answer. In first year locus, we don't worry about what is the shape of the locus mostly. We get this answer and we're quite happy. Now, is it difficult to tell if it's a circle or is it easy?
Easy, sir.
Why? X square and y square coefficients are equal and no x, y term. Alright? So, coefficient of x square equal to coefficient of y square and coefficient of x, y equal to 0. So, above equation represents a circle. Quotient x1 and quotient y are equal and you should write not equal to 0 also. Okay. If k is not equal to 1, then k greater than 0. You can write if k not equal to k greater than 0, quotient x square equal to quotient of y square, quotient x equal to 0. So above equation represents a circle. If k is equal to 1, this will become 0, this will become 0. We got x time, y time, and a constant time, it will become line. This is by coordinate geometry. You don't have to understand where is that circle, how it is circle and all that. Just you got the circle equation. In IP, you can write this for the last question of first exercise. But I'm asking you to write in the class notes because it's general theory and I want to tell another method.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, let P be any point on, what did you write there, sir?
Let P x comma y be any point on locus.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Yes, Tarna, is this clear to you? Ahijit, is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Ahijit?
Yes, sir.
Harshit, is this clear to you? Harshit, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Whoever not submitted the class notes of 5th and 6th day, the first 2 days of circles, please submit before the, as soon as, in the break time only you should submit. If you are not submitted, already gave enough time. Okay, Sandeep, completed copying this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, now let us see geometrically, based on pure geometry, how it is a circle. This is an explanation given by Apollonius. Okay, I'm purposely drawing a scalene triangle, but not too much obtuse, not that this is too left here, not in the middle, little left. Okay. I want to extend this. Then I want to draw the internal bisect. And also, I want to draw the perpendicular line to that, which is also the external bisector. I think you know, whenever you take two lines, in fact, you can do that easily. Don't draw this triangle. First, draw two lines. Then draw this angular bisector, it can easily be there perpendicular. Then just draw some horizontal line to form a triangle. So this is A, B, C, or this is A, this is B, this is B. This you extend it. Can you see this part of the board? Yes. This is E. Okay. So this line, is it internal bisector of angle APB? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And this line is external bisector, bisecting this angle. Maybe I like that. This angle equal to this angle. This angle is equal to this angle. So this is internal bisector, this is external bisector. Okay. I'll call this point as I and this point is E. I think all of you know, in a triangle, if an angular bisector is the meeting this at D, BD is to DC is equal to?
AB is to AC.
Yes, AB is to AC, yes. We know BD is to DC is equal to AB is to AC. Based on that, see basically what I'm doing, I'll tell you. I'm taking one point A, one point B. Any point in the XY plane where PA is to PB is K is to 1. So now, I is also one such point because IA is to IB will be same as PA is to PB based on that. And this rule is not only for internal bisector, it is also true for external bisector. Even if external bisector meets at D, BD is to DC will be again AB is to AC. Okay? So even I can say now, based on the theorem, which is called vertical angular bisector theorem, okay. Based on vertical angular bisector theorem, if PA by PB equal to IA by IB equal to EA by EB equal to K by 1, then AI is bisector of angle AP and AE, not AE, sir, PA. PE is bisector of exterior angle of angle AP. Okay. So what I am doing is I am not taking this as internal bisector first. This is to this is K is to 1. I took I such a way that AI is to IB is also K is to 1. Let me connect a sentence before this. Okay. Let AI is to IB equal to K is to 1 and PA is to PB is equal to K is to 1 and AE is to EB equal to K is to 1. Okay. I think one point P outside the lines where PB is K is to 1, one point on the AB where AI is to IB is K is to 1, one point outside where EA is to K is to 1. All these are some points on the locus that I am looking for. PA is to PB is K is to 1. Okay, only thing is that P is outside the line and I is on the line. Because this is to this is equal to this is to this, this has to be the bisector of this angle. It is not that I am starting with the bisector and saying this is to this, this is to this. Other way, this is to this, the same as this is to this, so it has to be bisector. The same way, this is to this, the same as this is to this, so this also has to be bisector. Okay, so you can state this formula, write this thing, and then write these things. Before all that, you can draw the figure if you want. The position of P may change every time, but PI is always internal bisector, PE is always external bisector. Dinesh Chandu, up to here, is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anvik, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Puneet?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear up to here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sachinani, is it clear? Are you there, Sachinarena?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Everybody, please put on your videos.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, once repeat how A is to EB equal to K is to 1, sir.
No, I am assuming. What was the question that we started? Forget about all this. The question sir, is...
Sir, we assume P is to PB equal to K is to 1, A no, is to...
Yes, sir. I would like all these things.
All three assume. Okay, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
P is one of the points where P is to P is K is to 1. This also. Maybe I'll explain a little bit right here. See what I'm trying to do. Let us say somebody tells you point A is there, point B is there. They don't know anything about circle and all those things. They just told you point A, point B are there. AB is to PB is equal to 2 is to 1. What is the locus of P? So what you will try to do, at least identify a few points where AB is to PB is 2 is to 1. Okay. So obviously, well, let's say I'll take 1 is to this one. Obviously, this is, we take the two points of bisection, this should be one other point, no? Okay, this is to this is 1 is to 2, right? There can be a point here also where this is to this will be 1 is to 2, that is also another point. Okay, so on this line, I can only find two, one internally, one externally. Outside, there will be so many. I can have a point here where this is to this is 1 is to 2. I can have a point here where this is to this is 1 is to 2. I can have a point somewhere here where this is to this is 1 is to 2, right? All those points will lie like this. What is the ends of diameter of that is this and this. The internal division, external division points are ends of diameter. So instead of that, what I told you is just say this point, any one of them has P. I just proved that this is the internal bisector of this angle. This is the external bisector of this angle. That's what I put. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Maybe in the beginning, I did not explain that a clear way. Okay. Anybody get a feeling that angle IPE will be 90 degrees?
Yes, sir, 90 degrees only.
How?
Sir, those are ends of a diameter. And if we draw
ends of diameter, we have to prove it. That is the, what we need to prove it. If you know IP is 90 degrees, then I'll tell you. But right,
sir,
now.
Sir, take the angle APE is alpha then, and EPA is beta, sir. We will get 2 alpha plus 2 beta equals to 180.
Yes, you are right. Okay, since I told the final answer already, somebody may have a little confusion what is that. But the thing is, you know what we are trying to do here? We identified one point dividing the ratio k is to 1 internally, one point dividing externally, and there are a whole lot of points outside that where this is to this k is to 1. Now my job is to prove this angle is 90 degrees every time, wherever it is, it doesn't matter. That is very easy. We take this way as alpha, alpha, this way as beta, beta. This total angle is 2 alpha plus 2 beta, 180 degrees. So 2 alpha plus 2 beta is 180 degrees, means alpha plus beta is 90 degrees. And if alpha plus beta is 90, angle IPE is equal to 90 degrees. Is I a fixed point or variable point?
What, sir?
In the question, point A is fixed point, point B is fixed point, K is to 1 ratio is also fixed, they are all given. Now, I is a fixed point or variable point?
Fixed point.
Fixed point. What about E?
Fixed only.
What about P?
It is variable.
Okay. Even though it is varying every time, it subtends 90 degrees, angle IP is 90 degrees, then what is the locus of P will be?
Circle.
With the IN here, then so that. So, locus of P is a circle with I and E as ends of diameter. Okay. This is called Apollonius circle. Okay, copy this. I'll explain in briefly once again if somebody had a doubt. Okay, those are completed. Try to see if AB distance is D, what is the radius of the circle going to be? If AB distance is D, what will be the radius? Your answer should be in terms of AB and K. That's all. Anushka, you understood so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay. K. Divya?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, we are trying to give you all possible things. For example, I'm sending the recording. So if somebody missed some 10, 15 minutes due to network, then they lose the continuity. Okay, they can actually watch that part of the video and get back. And Anushka is sending class notes every day. So if somebody missed that, you can write the class notes. We are sending IP solutions. Okay, so you cannot complain that I missed the class due to this. Unless your health is bad, that also you can watch the recordings later on. Except your health, there should not be any other excuse.
Sir.
Yes, please.
Diameter may be 2k AB by 1 minus k square.
2k AB by denominator?
1 minus k square.
Yeah, I think it's right. That 1 minus k square, you can put a mod because we'll take 2 cases, k greater than 1, k less than.
Yes, sir.
See, this is the beauty of coordinate geometry. Okay, there's a beauty of pure geometry. What is it you're able to tell? But without all this logic, just like that, we are able to tell in coordinate geometry that locus is a circle, right? In the first method, in the previous method, we got x square, y square coefficients are equal, no x, y times, so it is a circle, done, right?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. I'm going to erase this whole thing. Anybody needs more time? Varshit, roll number 122, completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have you finished exercise 1 year, Varshit?
Yes, sir. Doing, sir, third room.
Okay, few questions in left hand third room.
Yes, sir.
Okay, just I'm repeating the overall idea of the solution what we've done quickly. If somebody tells you L is a point, M is a point, they're fixed points, and they tell you PL is to PM is equal to 3 is to 2. What is the locus of P? Oh, there are a lot of points. There will be one point dividing the ratio 3 is to 2. There will be another point maybe here where PL is to PM is 3 is to 2. There may be a point here where this is to 3 is to 2. There may be a point here where this is to 3 is to 2. Here also. But they all will be lying on a circuit. You can understand somewhat the shape of that, whether oval or circle, you cannot know graphically. Okay, but it is a circle with these two ends of diameter. So, how did we prove? We took this point as I, this point as E, any other point as P. This is to this is 3 is to 2. This is to this is 3 is to 2. So this should be the internal bisector. These angles are again from here to here, from here to here, P is to 2. This is to this is 3 is to 2. This is also bisector, but bisector from this angle. So these two angles are equal, alpha and beta. This total is 2 alpha plus 2 beta 180. This is alpha plus beta 90. Even though this point position is changing, every time this angle is 90, angle in a semicircle is 90. So locus of this point with the circle will be used as tens of diameter. Is it okay now? What is the pattern overall?
Sir.
Yes.
At point E, it will become minus now, sir. Negative.
But minus see, 3. When I write PL by PM equal to 3 by 2, PL is positive or negative? PL is a length, positive. PL is a length, it is positive. How can the ratio of lengths? In section formula, we may say 3 is to 2 externally means take minus 3 is to 2 in a formula. Doesn't mean ratio can never be negative of the two lengths. That is the reason we write internally explicitly and externally explicitly. So we don't have to write minus. Okay, just a little bit more. Let us take a k greater than 1 case. What happens? This is A, this is B. K is to 1, that I will be somewhere here. K is. Can anybody tell me point E, which is dividing A is to B externally in the ratio k is to 1 and k is greater than 1? Okay. I also dividing k is to 1 only. E is also dividing in the ratio k is to 1. The ratio is PA is to PB equal to k is to 1. If k is greater than 1, apart from this point, the other point will be on this side or on this side?
Sir, beyond B, sir.
Beyond Bombay, this side. Why? Because this is bigger. Yes, this will be farther from A and nearer to B.
So it will be on this side. So E will be this.
Okay. Now, I want to know what is this length. This is k parts. This is one part. So this total is how many parts? K plus one.
K plus one.
So then this length can arrive AB into 1 by k plus 1?
Yes, sir.
When you are dividing a length L in the ratio M is to N, this part will be M by M plus N into L. This part will be N by M plus N into L. Everybody knows that, right? Okay, in the same way, this is k is to 1, so this part should be AB into 1 by k plus 1. Coming to this, there's a noise here, it takes a few minutes. From here to here, k parts, and from here to here, one part. So this will be k minus 1 parts. So this will be AB into 1 by k minus 1. Understand? Earlier this is k plus 1 part for internal division. For external division, this is k parts, this is one part, this will be k minus 1 parts. This is one part. So k minus 1 parts is AB, so one part will be 1 by k minus 1 field. Is it alright?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sorry for this noise. I cannot do anything. Okay. Now, if you add these two, that's the diameter. So, what the radius will be? IE by 2. IB plus BE by 2. That is, if you simplify this, AB by A plus 1, AB by K minus 1 by 2. You get AB, simplify it, finally become K by K square minus 2. Okay. And your circle will be like this. So whenever this ratio of K is more than 1, your circle B is inside and A is outside. And the radius will be this. Okay.
Sir.
If somebody want to find center also, I can tell you. I'll tell you later. Just take the radius. See, one should not worry if they have not understood this part too much or something. This is not like a very important formula. I'm just telling little extension so that you'll have a better idea about what is it graphically representing. Otherwise, I don't have to explain all these things, man. As such, they are not there in the syllabus.
Sir, Sarkar is asking to explain again.
Yes, Lokesh?
Saket is asking to explain again.
I saw in the chart. Okay. Saket, this part is clear to you? Saket, is this part clear to you?
No, sir. That part on level.
Okay. This part, just take it. Don't worry. Okay. After that, you add these two, that is diameter, half of that is radius. Is it okay? Okay, those who completed this, K less than 1, K is between 0 to 1. Try to draw the rough figure and try to get the radius there also. Okay, what is on the board? Everybody completed?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is K less than 1. 0 less than K less than 1. Okay, now I will be internal division. But E will be this side because this is less number, this is greater number. It should be closer to A than B. So it should be here. And again, this length is K is to 1. So this will be K by K plus 1 into A. This is K part. This is 1 part total, K plus 1 part. So K by K plus 1 into A. Coming to this one. This is k parts, this is one part, so this will be 1 minus k, and this is k, so k minus 1 minus k, this is k parts, this whole thing is one part, so this should be 1 minus k, so divide is 1 minus k, and multiply. So now, EI, is equal to EA plus K by 1 minus K AB plus by radius. This K by K plus 1 into A by. If I simplify this, K square and minus K square will cancel. K plus K proven again. K by 1 minus K square into A. Earlier we got in the denominator k square minus 1, now we got 1 minus k square. So not a problem. Put a mod for the total. And the circle will be like this. Here A is inside and B is outside. Earlier B inside, A outside. Now A inside B outside. Okay, all of you completed? Yes? Okay, my head is. Okay, anyway, I found the radius. I want to find the center. I, based on the section formula, I can write k into b plus 1 into a by k plus 1. mx2 plus nx1 by m plus 1 section formula. So k into second point, 1 into first point by this. So kb plus k by k plus 1. E, external ratio. So kb minus a, kb minus 1 into a. mx2 minus nx1 by k minus 1. Kb minus a by k minus 1. If you want center, it is the midpoint of kb. I. Okay, that is kb plus a by k plus 1. Kb minus a by k minus 1 by k. If I simplify this, what will I get? B into KB common, I get 2K, 2K square B. Regarding A, A into K minus 1 minus K minus 2, so minus 2K. By K square minus 1 into 2 will cancel. K square B minus A by K square minus 2. So this is the same. K square into second point minus first point by k square minus 1. And the radius we got already k by mod k square minus 1 k. K greater than 1, k less than 1, both are covered. So you can see now coordinate geometry way is one sense easier. And IP don't have to write the second solution, only coordinate geometry solution would write. Exercise 1A, last question. You write only the method 1, okay, by coordinate geometry. There also you can find center and radius from the third equation if you want to. This is just by pure geometry. There's a reason I spent so much time, because in complex numbers later on we'll get this concept. So I thought I'll give a geometrical explanation. If somebody could not understand fully, think about it later on, I can discuss once again, but not necessary, at least for IP exam or mains, maybe a little bit for advanced. See, has you understood everything?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Today, everybody has to submit exercise 1A, section 1 and section 2. Okay. Not section 3. Let section 3 I'll ask later on, maybe tomorrow. Only section 1 and section 2. But don't submit in the morning. I want you to submit after 5 o'clock only. Either today you can't submit, tomorrow morning also I don't mind. But don't submit before 5 o'clock. Because we have to just take stock of those who submitted class notes properly. So anybody not submitted first 2 days class notes, please submit in the break time. Okay, I'm going to address this whole thing. Okay, so yesterday, the day before yesterday in the class, we discussed about equation of a line, right? S1 equal to 0, and we derived it. Okay. So, a little more related to that. Okay, I'm not giving any number. If you have any number, you can give. Let's. Equation of tangent to circle x square plus y square equal to r square at r cos theta comma r sin theta is x cos theta plus y sin theta equal to r. Is also general tangent. Whatever theta you take, this one is always a tangent to circle. How this formula has come? Method 1, you can do S1 equal to 0. What is S1 means? X square, you write X into other X, you substitute this. R cos theta. Y square, you write Y into Y1 and other Y, you substitute R sin theta. Equal to R square. Cancel R. You get x cos theta plus y sin theta equal to method 2. This is theta, this is r. This point is only r cos theta comma r sin theta. By a normal form of a line, equation of tangent is x cos theta plus y sin theta equal to 1. When I told about parametric form r cos theta comma r sin theta, I told you graphically what is the theta. You take that point joined to the origin, the inclination of that is theta. That's how in the simple triangle, this is r cos theta and this is r sin theta. That's how we got. Okay. Now, if you want this tangent, it resembles normal form. The inclination of the normal is theta and this is, instead of p, it is r. Directly x cos theta plus y sin theta equal to r. This is s1 equal to 0. X into x1 plus y into y1 equal to r cos. In the place of x1, I have to put r cos theta. In the place of y1, I have to put r sin theta. Then you understand the Eppelmann circle thoroughly? Vithan, are you there in the class? It's okay, I can see. Saket, completed and understood this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. equation of tangent to circle x plus g cos theta, x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. At minus g plus r cos theta comma minus f plus r sin theta is x plus g into r cos theta, or x plus g cos theta, y plus f sin theta equal to r. Okay, compared to the previous one, this is just translated. Okay, by x is replaced with x plus g, y is replaced with y plus f. You know, you studied about translation of axis, right? Like, I don't think I need to give explanation for this. Simply do s1 equal to 0, it will come, or it is a translated of the previous one. Maybe I can state another formula. Equation of tangent to circle x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square equal to r square. At h plus r cos theta comma k plus r sin theta is x minus h r cos theta, x minus h cos theta, y minus k sin theta equal to r. This you can easily see like translation of the previous formula, that is x square plus y plus r square. X became x minus h, y became y minus k. That's it. Like translation of x. The same way that the h is minus g and that k is minus h. Okay. One more formula you can write. Two more formulas related to this. Equation of comma joining points theta 1 and theta 2 is x cos theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2. Y sine theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2 equal to R cos theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. Okay, so what is joining points theta 1 and theta 2? I can write on x square plus y square equal to r. Equation of R joining points theta 1 and theta 2 on x square plus y square is this. What is point theta 1 means? R cos theta 1 comma R sin theta 1. What is point theta 2 means? R cos theta 2 comma R sin theta 2. Just a short way of expressing that. When I say point 30 degrees, R cos 30 degrees, R sin 30 degrees. When I say point 75 degrees, R cos 75 degrees, R sin 75 degrees. We'll derive this formula. Okay. Basically, for this, we have a circle with center origin. There is a chord. This point is r cos theta 1, or let us theta degrees. R cos theta 2, comma r sin theta 2. This point is r cos theta 1, comma r sin theta 1. You join them, you want to find the line, it is this. Okay. So we'll derive this. Method 1, you can use s1 plus s2 equal to s12. This is a chord joining x1, y1, x2, y2. Other day we derived this formula, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. We just said how it came directly. There's no in-between steps. So s1 means x into r cos theta 1. Y into r sin theta 1 minus r square. What is s1 means? Substituting 50%. X square, you write x into x, 1x as it is, other x you substitute r cos theta 1. Y square, you write y into y, 1y as it is, and other y you write r sin theta 1. So this is s1. S2 means x into r cos theta 2, y into r sin theta 2 minus r square. And the right hand side, S12 means substituting 50% this, 50% this. R cos theta 1 into R cos theta 2 plus R sin theta 1 into R sin theta 2 minus R. What is this? X square, I wrote X into X. 1X first X coordinate, 1X second X coordinate. Y square, I wrote Y into Y. 1 by first coordinate, 1 by second coordinate minus R. If anybody has doubt what is the meaning of S1 or S2, I'll explain once again. Please tell me if you are not clear about what is this x square, x into x and substituting that x here. Half of it. Roll number 5, are you there in the class? Roll number 5. V. Harika, have you finished exercise 1 year mostly?
Complicated, sir. No doubt.
Okay. 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 Wednesday morning, at morning 9 o'clock, everybody will have an exam on exercise 1A, IP test. Okay, 1 hour test.
When, sir?
Wednesday morning, 9 o'clock. Oh, Wednesday, sorry, afternoon. Wednesday afternoon, let us keep at 4 o'clock. All right?
Sir, next week, do we have exams, sir?
That I'll find out and I'll tell you, okay?
Okay.
Sir, exam along with examples?
What?
IP exam is with along with examples, sir? Or only exercise 1?
I am giving only exercise, but you can go through examples just for clarity, okay?
Yes, sir.
I'll give only from exercise.
Sir, how many exercises, sir?
Only exercise 1A.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so we have to simplify this now. 1 minus R square I can cancel. 1 R everywhere I can cancel. And combine these two. This and this. x into cos theta 1 plus cos theta 2. Combine these two. Y into sin theta 1 plus sin theta 2. And then these two r square will come common and r will cancel. Of course, this r square is also there. And then write that also. X into r here. Y into r here. And right side r square into cos theta 1 cos theta 2 plus sin theta 1 sin theta 2 plus 1. R and square can cancel. And apply transformations. 2 cos theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2 cos theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. This is 2 sin theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2 cos theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. This one right here only I can write cos A cos B plus sin A sin B is cos A minus 2. Which is cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2 plus 1 with an R. But 1 plus cos theta, I can write 2 cos square theta by 2. Which is 2 cos square theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. So from here to here we apply transformations. From here to here we apply transformations. Cos A cos B plus sin A sin B is cos A minus B. And 1 plus cos theta is 2 cos square theta by 2. So we revise transformations, compound angles, multiple submultiple angles. Okay, so now everywhere cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2 have been cancelled, right? So this is x cos theta 1 plus cos theta 2 by 2. Y sin theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2 into 2 cos theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. This is R cos theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2 into 2 cos theta 1 minus theta 2. I can cancel this. This is a formula. Okay. The equation of the part joining theta 1 and theta 2. This is S1, this is S2, this is S12. Whatever is possible, we have to common and cancel and combine these to separate this whole thing. And then a little bit of simplification. So we'll be using trigonometry in many places, okay? Like here we used. The next method, I want to do it from the figure only by using normal form of a line. If somebody wants, they can think about it. Same question. Can we complete it? Can I erase this?
Yes, sir, completed.
Okay. this angle is theta 1. And this angle is theta 2. What is this angle? Can anybody say?
The middle theta 2 plus theta 1 by 2.
The average of this, which will be theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2. What is this angle?
Theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2.
This is theta 1 plus theta 2. So theta 1 minus theta 2, I'll make it into two equal parts. So this part will be theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. This part also theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. So this I'll call O, this is A, this is midpoint M. You take triangle OMD. OMD, this is arc radius. And this angle is theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. What is OM length will be from this figure? Right angle triangle.
R cos theta.
R cos theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. Correct? Okay. If you want a line in normal form, you should know the inclination of the normal. What is the inclination of the normal?
Theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2.
Theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2. Right?
Yes, sir.
So if you are finally looking for your line, this is M. This angle is theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2, but this length is R cos theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. You can use X cos alpha plus Y sin alpha equal to P. Okay. So by normal form, equation of line AB is equal to X cos, if I call this as alpha, X cos alpha plus Y sin alpha equal to OM. That alpha is theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2. And that OM is directly R cos theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2. That's it. Actually, I wrote so much just from the figure directly you can tell. That's my point. Am I correct? Everybody could see what is the inclination of the normal and what is the length of the perpendicular distance from origin to that, so we are able to write the formula as it is.
Yes, sir.
Saptarshi Mandal, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So first year one may think what is the use of normal form of a line they are using. It's quite useful, right? Sometimes.
Yes, sir.
After 1 or 2 days, I want to conduct some 40 minutes class in the afternoon, only for discussing past year mains questions in circles. Is it okay?
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Maybe from Thursday I can do it because Wednesday afternoon will keep exam. Thursday onwards.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, if you conduct class, then inform us in morning only.
We'll keep every day from Friday on.
Okay.
Okay, time is almost up, but anyway, third method will be what I want to do is, you know, two points on a line, you can find the line equation, you don't need circle, right? Just by 2-point formula. I want to find slope first and then do it. Okay, I'm going to erase this. Anybody needs more time?
One minute, sir.
Okay. Okay, the simple 2-point form, I'm sure you realize in especially first year tangents and normals chapter, you will realize this. After finding the slope, like here y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, and I apply transformation sin c minus sin d and cos c minus cos d. Cos by sin, if I wanted, I would have written cot. But you know, if I written cot, the simplification is not that easy. So better to leave it as cos by sin. So basically what we use, 2-point form of a line, y minus y1, this part is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1, or y minus y1 equal to slope into x minus x1. We separately simplified the slope in the beginning by using transformations. Now this denominator I multiplied here, expanded the whole thing. This and this together I combined, it looks like cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So from here to here, it is cos A minus B. When you simplify, you got the same form. Namrata, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So those who finished copying this, they can leave classes over. But if anybody any doubt, I will be there. If you want to ask, you can ask. Thank you.